सिंगापुर का, जहां विदेश मंत्री सुषमा स्वराज क्षेत्रीय प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस सम्मेलन को संबोधित कर रही हैं।
Deputy Prime Minister in the office of the Prime Minister of Malaysia. His Excellency Tunis Samu Begu, Special Envoy to India and South Asia for Infrastructure in the office of the Prime Minister of Malaysia. Sarbanand Sonowal, Chief Minister of Assam. The wonderful Indian diaspora in Singapore and the ASEAN region, I have interacted with so many of you on social media. It's a pleasure to be with you in person. Friends and partners of India, thank you for your support and abiding faith in India's partnership with Singapore and ASEAN. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, greetings and best wishes for 2018 and a very warm welcome the ASEAN India Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. Pravasi Bharatiya Divas ke avsar par aap sabka hardik swagat hai. Friends, ASEAN and India have completed 25 years of partnership. On January 25th, Prime Minister Modi will host the commemorative summit in New Delhi. And on January 26th, India will have an honor to host the leaders of all 10 ASEAN nations as guests of honor on our Republic Day. This is not just a symbol of the value we attach to our partnership with ASEAN. It is also the affirmation of the common destiny of 2 billion people of India and Southeast Asia. It is a great pleasure to be here in Singapore, the chair of ASEAN this year. Singapore has been at the crossroads of this region's history. And it is now the springboard of the Southeast Asia's march to the future. Here, in this great nation, the currents of commerce and culture have converged. Human achievement has scaled great heights, and dreams have become realities in a generation. Singapore has also been a political, intellectual, and economic bridge between India and ASEAN. It is now one of India's major strategic partners and our gateway to the East. Not just Singapore, and not just Singapore, the whole of Southeast Asia is on the rise in partnership with each other and the rest of the world. This region is integral to Asia's success and to the possibility of an Asian century. One of the earliest destinations of my journey as External Affairs Minister was to Southeast Asia. Since then, I visited this region many times. Each time I visit, I'm struck by the depth of our interconnected histories and even more by our interlinked future. For more than 2,000 years, India and Southeast Asia have engaged and enrich each other in every walk of life. Across Southeast Asia's magnificent diversity, I see the symbols of our ties on the streets, in the homes, in the grace of the people, in the grandeur of temples, in our handlooms, weaves and textiles, in the rituals of diverse faiths, in the timeless majesty of epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata, in the wisdom of folklore, in the symbols and sounds of languages, in the poetry of the dances, in the melody of the music, and in the flavors of the food. The depth of our civilization and culture images are infinite. And I also see our shared values and our common interests, the opportunities of our economies and the risks of our nations, the hopes and aspirations of our youth and challenges to their future. Above all, I see the promise and potential of a defining partnership between India and Southeast Asia. So much of the potential comes from the human links between India and Southeast Asia, from the dynamic and talented Indian diaspora in the region. My friends from diaspora, we have come here at different times from the circumstances of history and the opportunities of global economy. We take delight in your accomplishments that span every field. We are proud of your commitment and contribution to the progress of your countries. We honor your connections with India, the land of your heritage. We deeply value your role in nurturing the ties between India and Southeast Asia. All these strands have come together in this ASEAN-India Pravasi Bharatiya Divas today. This is an event that certainly keeps our diaspora at the center, but our objectives are broader. My Ayurve diaspora ka pune pune hriday se swagat karti hun. We are here to reaffirm our commitment and redouble our efforts to shape the course of our journey ahead in the future of India ASEAN. ASEAN and our world, this is a time of milestones. Now I'll count the milestones. Wo kaun kaun se meel ke patthar hain jo is saal mein hone wale hain? Ye saal meel ke pattharon ka saal hai. Ye varsh milestones ka varsh hai. This is a time of milestones. One. Last year, independent India turned 70. Pichle saal Bharat 70 varsh ka hua. लगता है आपको स्पीच हिंदी में चाहिए. शाम को मिलेगी. शाम को मैं वादा करती हूँ आज जो गाला डिनर होगा उस पर मैं केवल हिंदी में बोलूंगी. ठीक है. इस समय क्योंकि बहुत से लोग बिना हिंदी समझने वाले बैठे हैं इसलिए मैंने अंग्रेजी में बोलने का फैसला किया लेकिन शाम को केवल हिंदी. आगे बढ़े. आई वाज सेइंग वी आर हियर टू रीअफर्म आवर कमिटमेंट एंड रीडबल आवर एफर्ट्स टू शेप द कोर्स ऑफ आवर जर्नी अहेड फॉर द फ्यूचर ऑफ इंडिया आसियान एंड आवर वर्ल्ड. दिस इज अ टाइम ऑफ माइलस्टोन्स. लास्ट ईयर इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया टर्न 70. इट हैज रीगेन्ड द स्पिरिट ऑफ यूथ एंड इट लुक्स टू द फ्यूचर with renewed confidence and optimism. It comes from the energy and enterprise of our people and the commitment of our proactive, transparent and responsive government. Friends, in India, economic reforms are bold and ambitious. Infrastructure expansion is on an unprecedented scale. Investments in skills and manufacturing has a new sense of urgency and priority. Digital India is accelerating growth and inclusion. And access to basic needs of our people is no longer a distant dream, but a time-bound commitment. As India takes a place among the top economies in the world, it will be an anchor of global economy and a force of stability in the world. ASEAN has reached the golden milestone of 50 years. Bharat 70 ka hua, ASEAN 50 ka hua. It has been when Southeast Asia was a global fault line. When it was born, Southeast Asia was a global fault line, a theater of a brutal war and a region of uncertain nations. Today, ASEAN has unified 10 countries behind a common purpose, and it has become an anchor of broader regional integration and cooperation. For India, ASEAN leadership and centrality is essential to peace and prosperity for a rapidly changing Indo-Pacific region. ASEAN-India partnership has reached 25 years. Bharat 70 ka hua, ASEAN 50 ka hua, aur ASEAN-Bharat Maitri 25 varsh ki hua. Maine kaha tha na ye milestones ka varsh hai. Ye teen milestones, Bharat 70 ka hua, ASEAN 50 ka hua, और भारत आसियान मैत्री 25 वर्ष की. सिंस देन आवर डायलॉग पार्टनरशिप हैज इवॉल्व्ड इनटू अ स्ट्रेटेजिक पार्टनरशिप. ASEAN region is at the heart of our Act East policy, जिसके सिंबल के तौर पे चीफ मिनिस्टर आसाम सर्वानंद सोनोवाल यहाँ उपस्थित हैं। With each Southeast Asian country, we have growing political, economic, defence and cultural relations, and growing connectivity has reinforced proximity. Today, 16 Indian cities are connected to Singapore. A trilateral highway project from India to Thailand is making progress. We plan to expand this further to connect India with other ASEAN countries. Our trade agreements with ASEAN region are among the most ambitious with any region. Our partnership in regional institutions, including the East Asia Summit, helps advance peace and stability in the region. The strength of the partnership and of India's engagement in the ASEAN region lies in the clarity of the principles that we share. We believe that when all nations adhere to international rules and norms, when we conduct relations on the basis of sovereign equality and mutual respect, our nations feel secure and our economies prosper. So, India and ASEAN have a future full of possibilities, but also of enormous responsibilities. There is much that creates synergies for us, from demography to dynamism of our economies, from proximity to the talent of our people. ASEAN is India's fourth largest trading partner. Singapore alone is India's leading source and destination for investments. Over 6,000 Indian companies are registered here. ASEAN region is also a major destination for the rapidly growth onbound tourism. As India's economy grows, our ties will deepen, our trade will multiply, and investment flows will grow. States play a vital role in India's progress, and they are important for advancing India's economic ties to the world. Today, as I mentioned earlier, we have Shri Sarbanand Sonowal, Chief Minister of Assam, with us. He is a symbol of resurgence of India's Northeast, as mentioned by Javed Ashraf. Our Northeast region will prosper when it is better connected to Southeast Asia, and when Northeast becomes a bridge to Southeast Asia, we will be closer to realizing our hopes for India-ASEAN ties.
तो अभी आप ये सीधी तस्वीरें देख रहे थे सिंगापुर से, जहां विदेश मंत्री सुषमा स्वराज क्षेत्रीय प्रवासी भारतीय सम्मेलन को संबोधित कर रही थी और वो तीन देशों की यात्रा पर गई हुई हैं, दक्षिण एशियाई पूर्वी जो दक्षिण पूर्व एशियाई देश हैं उनमें। और मकसद ये है इन तीनों देशों की यात्रा का कि भारत के साथ इन तीनों ही देशों के और खासकर दक्षिण पूर्व एशिया में जितने भी देश हैं उनके साथ तमाम जो रिश्ते हैं उनको मजबूत करना, चाहे फिर वो रणनीति की बात हो, व्यापार की बात हो, निवेश की बात हो, इन तमाम क्षेत्रों में कैसे द्विपक्षीय जो संबंध हैं वो मजबूत हैं, वो इस यात्रा का मकसद है। और इसी कड़ी में विदेश मंत्री सुषमा स्वराज इन दिनों तीन देशों की यात्रा पर गई हुई हैं। तो इस बुलेटिन में